Yeah, there is only one slide with minimalist references. Okay, and I take the blackboard. J'ai attrapé froid cette nuit, donc je la vois un peu. So, I work in a constructive context. I work in Bishop-style mathematics, which are minimalist mathematics, which are good for every philosophy of mathematics, I think. When you read the proof in Bishop's book, if you are a classical mathematician, you agree with the proof. And if you are a constructive mathematician of a different school, also, in general, you agree. The fact is that theorems in Bishop's book or in Richmond's book have all an algorithmic content. It is the main point for me. And also, I want to avoid dependent choice, and I will explain why. And the work, which is a work in progress with Asia Mahbubi, she works on Cork, and she knows very well real algebra, because he had translated in Cork. So I use dynamical algebra. What is dynamical algebra? It is a purely computational version of geometric theories. We have only atomic formulae, no connector, no quantifier. And our theorems are only dynamical rules. Example, the dynamical rule for a local ring is the following one. If x plus y is invertible, then there exists u such that xu equal 1, or exists v such that yv equal 1. So I have said there is no connector and no quantification. So what is the problem? The problem is it is that this is not a formula. This is a way of computing. This R means you open two branches of computations. So in French, we write OU, because OU is also R or open, ouvrir. But in English, I don't know how to work. This existential quantifier is not a new formula. It is only in this branch, you add a parameter u, and you assume xu equal 1. So there is no logic. It is only computational machinery. And in fact, it is equivalent to geometric theories. But since there is no logic, very often things are more simple. For example, when you take the axioms for fields, so this is a commutative ring plus the axioms of fields. Now we want to add axioms saying that a polynomial has a root. For example, so this means that before having this axiom, we compute only with this trick, which is open branches. Now I have a new trick, and what is the meaning? The meaning, you prove very easily that adding this axiom doesn't change things which there is no exist. When you have a dynamical rule without existence, there you prove exactly the same thing here and when adding this. And this means, in classical mathematics, that a field has an algebraic closure. But in constructive mathematics, the fields, general discrete fields, are no algebraic closure. So the fact that adding these axioms doesn't change dynamical rules where there is no existential quantifier proves is the constructive form of algebraic closure of a field. Mm-hmm. There are, with dynamical algebra, there are two very important facts. When you are first order, when we have no infinite or infinite disjunctions. When you are first order, you have adding classical logic is conservative. So, dynamical rules are the intuitively they are for all exist rules, and for sentences for all exist there is no conflict between classical and constructive mathematics. So this is a very important thing for doing dynamical algebra because we don't want to contradict mathematicians, usual mathematicians. And also, there is a scolemization. It is conservative. Mm-hmm. There is a nice proof by Coquin and Bezem, but it is not actually written. It has to appear on archive. It's a very simple proof. It's very surprising. And I think we have to understand this very well because scolemization seems to be related to choice axiom. In fact, the proof is so elementary that what happens with choice axiom in this context? So, if you use general geometric theories, you have infinite disjunctions. So there is a theorem of Bahr, saying that adding classical logic is conservative. But in fact, this theorem is not clear for me, at least, because I have some counterexamples. And so certainly, I don't understand well what is the meaning of Bahr's theorem. But in fact, it is good for intuition. When you have something which is proved classically with in a geometric form, we think that we can find a constructive proof. So transform this in a... It is not as automatic as the previous one in first order. In first order, there is a transformation of proof which is clear. But when we are second order, external proofs are necessary in order to certify infinite disjunctions. So we are not inside the theory, we have to speak from the outside. And in the outside part of the theory, we try to be as minimalist as possible. So to work in Bishop styles and without dependent choice. So now I speak about the algebra of real numbers. Hmm. What is the meaning? The meaning is that we have something that similar to R. We don't know exactly what it is because there are many constructive possibilities for R. And we know that some things are impossible to... we have to avoid some things. We have to avoid discreteness. The axioms x equals R, x invertible, is the same thing as LPO, which is a non-constructive principle, saying that for any sequence of integer, I can say at the beginning when I see the sequence, but what is the seeing the sequence, if it is identically zero or not. So this is forbidden. This is also forbidden the total order, the linear order. This corresponds to LLPO, which is a principle a little weaker than LPO, and also not x equals zero implies x equals zero. This is Markov principle, and it cannot be written in the sign inside in the context of a dynamical algebra, but this principle is also not x equals zero implies no, it is a x equals zero in the Bishop tile. It is the opposite of being invertible. So, okay, you are right. So I have not to say this. I have to say what exactly? Not x invertible. Yeah, you are. The other is true, trivially. X invertible. This is Markov principle, but it is not. It is impossible to write it in inside the dynamical theory. So you know that there is a wonderful theory of a real closed discrete field, which was invented by Tarski, and with this theory. All is wonderful because the theory is decidable and all is finite. A closed semi-algebraic set is the finite union of basic closed semi-algebraic set. All problems you question have a finite solution. So it is a dream, the real closed field when they are discrete. But when they are not discrete, as the ring of real numbers in various constructive settings, the algebra is not known. It is not well known. It is only analysis is better known than algebra for real numbers. It is strange. So what we have? We have this one. X plus y positive implies x positive or y positive. So we can try to use axioms of a real closed field which are clearly not of this type, the other axioms, and to add this axiom. And what you add is very weak. For example, we cannot prove that there is a sup of two elements. And also we can, there is a Nighting axiom saying that not And this is an interesting axiom, but it is not the it is not it is impossible to write it in a dynamical way. So we try to avoid this axiom. So what is the basis of for working in order to elaborate a dynamical theory of real numbers, of algebra of real numbers? The basis is continuity, extensions of well-defined semi-algebraic functions. This is the basic idea. What is a well-defined semi-algebraic function? It is not clear. Surely, well-defined semi-algebraic continuous, excuse me. The field of algebraic real numbers is a discrete real closed field, and so for this field, all is perfect. And we have a semi-algebraic function which are defined in a correct way in all textbooks of real algebra. And when such a function is continuous with for all epsilon exist delta definition, in fact they are continuous on every compact, not compact, it is not compact here. There are two holes, too many holes in these things. They are closed and bounded. Compact semi-algebraic means closed and bound. So for this field, which is a nice field, when you have a continuous semi-algebraic function, it is automatically uniformly continuous on closed bounded sets. So there is an extension to R. There is also a theorem which says that classical mathematics, any semi-algebraic continuous function from Rn to R can be obtained as a point in a family defined as a real point, defined over algebraic number. So you have something that of the kind Ralge n plus R to R Ralge, which is continuous. You take the prolongation by continuity, and you have R parameters that are real. And this gives all, in classical mathematics, all semi-algebraic continuous functions. So we have a definition. We have a nice definition. I think it is surely impossible to prove that a function which is with the usual definition of semi-algebraicity, it is surely impossible to prove constructively which is, that the function is of this type. But it is the same thing as when Bishop defines a continuous function as a locally uniformly continuous function. So here we define semi-algebraic continuous functions as in this way. So all is based on R-alg. So this is the plan. And why we don't want dependent choice? Because in the book of Bishop, there are, when he uses dependent choice, we are not very happy. It is not so uniform. For example, with dependent choice, you prove that you define C as R over square root of minus 1, and you take a polynomial P. And Bishop proves that this polynomial has a complex root with dependent choice. He uses dependent choice. And what happens when computing on a computer? It is not this thing that happens. On a computer, you find in the complex plane, here are three roots, here are two roots, here is one root, here is one root, and so on. This is how goes the computation. When you refine the computation, perhaps this becomes later 1 plus 2, or perhaps it remains 3. We don't know in advance. So in order to have a good understanding of, on the what happened in computation, we have to avoid saying, I can imagine I go to the infinity, in order to obtain at least one root. So we avoid the dependent choice, and the theory that we try to manage don't use have only theorems which are provable without dependent choice. So when trying to make things clear, we added the function sup, which was not available. We have added the function a over b when a square over b when 0 a b. It is a continuous function. We can make this function everywhere defined, for example, by taking inf of a b to the square. So we have not. So this is a function which is well defined on real numbers. It is a fraction, but when the denominator is zero, the fraction has to be zero clearly. And we had also a virtual real root of monic polynomial. This has been invented, I think, 20 years ago, in order to make computations more uniform. So when you have a polynomial which has three roots, for example, it is good. And if you are here, then you take here the root of the derivative. These two roots are replaced by the root of the derivative. And so there is a possibility to give n virtual roots continuously. Depending on the coefficient. And when we have made this work, we found that we have a structure which is well known in algebra, in real algebra, which is called the real closed rings, and not real. And so a real closed field could be a real closed local ring. So it is rather satisfying. But in fact, there are elements in the skies which are, there are rings of this case, in this case, with zero divisors. So it is not completely satisfactory. We don't know if it is possible to obtain, in a first order way, a better thing. We have tried to add archimedianity, which is a big O. But this doesn't remove this local real closed ring with the zero divisor. And so we have think that I've thought that it is necessary to do things more uniformly than only. And in fact, the idea is that if we are able to understand real numbers in a very uniform way and in a dynamical way, surely we will be able to understand all minimal structures. This is the idea. And all minimal structures are a very wonderful thing. It is a large extension of real closed fields using, for example, analytic functions. You add to a real closed field all analytic functions on an interval, and you have to complete this way, I think. So the function is analytic in a neighborhood. And so we see with this kind of function that there are only finitely many zeros, except where the function is constant, equals zero. But so with all minimal structures, the wonderful world of a real closed field is always here, but only in classical mathematics. So we have to understand how to deal constructively with this world. And here you have a new book, which is absolutely fantastic. And in fact, these are all minimal structures. Theory of transseries. So I don't understand, but surely it is fantastic. So what we have done is to the idea, but we don't are sure that this works completely. The idea is to introduce. Here is a trick. Introduce sorts for E is a closed interval. For semi-algebraic continuous function here, or for definable function, continuous definable functions in the case of all minimal structures. But in constructive setting, we have it is impossible to understand what is a constructive function, a constructive continuous function, without its modulus of continuity. So with moduli of continuity, and in fact it appears that in all minimal structures a continuous definable function has a continuous definable modulus of continuity. So all seems to work. Also there is a, you have to use differentiable or infinitely differentiable definable functions So you have to add the subsort of this function, and you have to define what is the derivative. And the derivative is defined by saying that so you have to say that there is a continuous function which extends this function. This function is well defined when x is different from y. And the good constructive definition of the derivative is this one. This, it is a continuous function that extends the function when it is defined. So this is due to Carathéo theory, I think, and also used by Stoltzenberg. And so we are apparently able to define all what is needed in order to describe in a dynamical way what are O-minimal structures. What is the problem? The problem is that we don't know any O-minimal structure constructively. So we have the axioms, but we have to prove that the usual models we have in the classical literature works constructively with the constructive actions. So it is a big problem. So thank you.